Hello everyone, welcome to Pabbly Connect. Today in this video, we are going to integrate two software applications, Shopify and MailChimp. So the use case here is, whenever a new order is placed in Shopify, automatically add new member or subscriber in MailChimp. Now let us know what these two software applications are all about. So Shopify is an e-commerce platform where you can set up your online store and sell your products, whereas MailChimp is an email marketing software. Although Shopify and MailChimp have some native integration between them, but this integration has certain limitations, and that is why we are going to use Pabbly Connect. So Pabbly Connect is an integration software which will help you to transfer data from Shopify to MailChimp. The best part here is you don't require any knowledge of coding. So let me show you this on my screen. Okay, so here I am at Google. And now I will go to this URL section over here and I'm going to type pabbly.com. Okay, so this is the website of Pabbly, and now I will hover over this product section from here and I'm going to click on connect. Okay, so now I am going to sign into my account. Okay, so now because I've already signed into my account, that is why I am here. You can also sign up for free and create your free account in just 2 minutes. Here, I would like to mention one more thing. You can try out this integration in Pabbly Connect absolutely free. So if you want, you can create your account right now and set up your own automation. The link is available in the description box below the video. Okay, so now I will scroll down. And here at Connect, I am going to click on Access Now. Okay, so this is the dashboard of Pabbly Connect. And now we are going to create a new workflow by clicking on this button over here. Okay, so now I'm going to give a name to this workflow and I'm going to name it as Shopify Integrations. Create. Okay. So now here in choose app, first I am going to choose Shopify. Okay. Now in trigger event, according to our workflow, whenever a new order is created in Shopify will be our trigger event over here. So new order. So now you can see we have various trigger events available. You can select whichever trigger event you prefer. And if you don't get the trigger event of your choice, you can contact our team at admin@pabbly.com and our team will help you. Now I'm going to click on new order. Okay, so now you might have a question in your mind that what is this term called trigger? Let me explain you that automation runs on the concept of triggers and actions. It is all about when something happens, do this. For example, when a sale happens, send an email. In our case, whenever a new order is created in Shopify will be our trigger event over here. So now when you come down here, you can see this term called webhook URL. So webhook is an essential way to get data from an external software at Pabbly's end. So this webhook helps you to build a connection between the trigger software application and Pabbly Connect. So here, after choosing the app and choosing the trigger event, what we do is we copy this webhook URL from here and we go and paste it inside the trigger software application, which is Shopify over here. Okay, so now you can see the instructions are written over here. You can just follow them carefully. So now I'm going to go to my Shopify account. Okay, so this is my Shopify account over here. Now I'm going to click on the settings over here. And you can see this notification. So I'm going to click on notifications. Okay, now I'm going to scroll down. And here you can see webhooks. So I'm going to create a webhook over here. Okay, so event here is order creation. So I am going to click on order creation. Let us search for it. You can see order creation. Okay, format will be JSON URL. So here you have to paste the webhook URL that you got from Pabbly Connect. I'll just copy it and I am going to paste it. Webhook API version will remain same. Save webhook. Okay, so we have successfully created a webhook and we have saved it. Now I'll go back to Pabbly Connect and here I am going to click on capture webhook response. So now it is waiting for webhook response. That means now whenever a new order will be created in Shopify, Pabbly Connect will capture the data. So now I'm going to go to my Shopify and here you can see online store. So I'm going to open it in new tab. Okay, so now I'm going to click on catalog and I am going to buy a camera. Okay, now I'll buy it. So now here, contact information, I'm going to enter a contact information here. So the email is going to be emily15@gmail.com. Okay, first name Emily, last name Clo, company I'll put here TVS, address E24 10 number market, Arera Colony, city Bhopal, state Madhya Pradesh, pin code. Okay, phone. Okay, now continue to shipping. Okay, so now I'm going to continue to payment. Okay, so now in card number, I'm going to write one. Name on card, I'll write your bogus gateway. I'm here doing a test card payment. Expiry date. Okay, security code. Okay, pay now. Okay, so we have successfully created an order here in Shopify. You can see we have bought Canon EOS 1500D digital SLR camera. Okay, so now let's go to Pabbly Connect. Okay, so you can see Pabbly Connect has already captured the data over here. The email is here, created date, updated, okay. If you go down, you can see the amount is also here. So we have successfully finished our first step integration here. Now I'm going to save it. Okay, so now I'm going to begin with our second step integration, where we are going to integrate MailChimp and Pabbly Connect. So now I'm going to click on this plus button over here and I'm going to add an action step. So here in Choose App, I am going to choose MailChimp. And in action event, according to our workflow, whenever new order is created in Shopify, we want to add new member or subscriber in MailChimp. That is why add new member will be our action event over here. Now you can see we have other action events available. You can select whichever action event you want according to your choice. And if you don't get the action event of your choice, you can contact our team at admin@pabbly.com and our team will help you. So now I'm going to click on this add new member because this is my action event over here. Okay, so now I'm going to click on connect with MailChimp. Okay, create new or select existing credentials. Now here, if you have any existing credential like this, you can directly click on it and you can go ahead. But here I am going to click on new credentials. Okay, so here after clicking on new credentials, you can see it is asking us for the API key and the data center. So in order to get your API key, what you have to do is you have to log into your MailChimp account. So I've already opened my MailChimp account over here. This is the dashboard. Now I'm going to click on my account settings over here. And now I'll click on account. Okay, so here you can see this extras over here. I'm going to click on this extras tab and here you can see API keys. Okay, so now when you come down here, you can see your API keys displayed over here. If you want, you can also create a new key and then copy it and paste it inside Pabbly Connect. I am just going to copy this from here. I'll go back to Pabbly Connect and I'm going to paste it here. Okay, now data center. So you can get your data center in your subdomain of your MailChimp account URL. If you go to your MailChimp account, here you can see this URL. So here in subdomain, you can see US2. So I'll just copy it and I'll come back to Pabbly Connect and I'll paste it here. So now this API key and data center are going to help us to build a connection between MailChimp and Pabbly Connect. Now I'm going to click on save. Okay, so now here you can see we have some empty fields and we have to fill the information that we have got from our webhook response. We'll just map these details. So first here you can see choose audience list. This is a required field over here. So you might have created some list in your MailChimp account and if you haven't, you can also create it. If I go to my MailChimp account, I'll click on audience over here. And in manage audience, I'm going to click on view audiences. So here you can see I have this one audience list called Pabbly. Now because my account is not upgraded, that is why I cannot create a new audience list over here. But you can easily create it if your account is upgraded. So here I am going to let the audience list be Pabbly itself. That is why it has mapped over here. If you have many audience lists, when you click on this drop down menu, it will be displayed over here. Okay, first name. Now I'll map the first name of our customer from Shopify. So first name is here Emily. last name. Let me map the last name as well. Here, Chloe. Okay, email address. I'll map the email address. Okay. Select the status of the subscriber. So it can be subscribed, unsubscribed, clean, pending, transactional. I'll let it be subscribed. Now tag. Here you can enter any kind of tag for your subscriber. So if I go back to MailChimp, I'll show you. Here you can see tags. So you can see I have all these tags over here. If you want, you can also create a tag. So I'll just create a new tag over here. Shopify order create. Okay. So now I want whichever subscriber comes from Shopify orders should have this tag called Shopify order. So now I'm going to write this over here. Now you have to remember that you have to enter the tags using double quote. That is why I am going to put it over here and I'll write Shopify order. Now, if you want to put more than one tag, you can just use comma over here and then you can write the other tags as well. But here I am just going to put one tag. That is why no comma. So now we have filled all these fields over here. Now I'm going to click on save and send test request. Okay, so we have our API response over here, you can see. Okay, so we have successfully finished our integration of Shopify and MailChimp here. I'm just going to save it. Okay, so now let's go to MailChimp and see if a new subscriber is created there with the email emily15@gmail.com and with the name Emily Klo. So I'll go to my MailChimp account and here you can see all contacts. So I'm going to click on all contacts. Okay, so here you can see emily15@gmail.com. First name is Emily, last name is Klo. And if you go and scroll down, here you can see the tag is here, Shopify order, and you can see it is subscribed. So we have successfully finished our integration. Now every time a new order is created in Shopify, a subscriber will be created in MailChimp automatically. So now here our integration is successful. Now I'm going to show you this process again with one more example so that you can understand how this integration takes place in real time. So now what I'm going to do is I'll go to my Shopify store and I'm going to create a new order. So I'll go to my Shopify store catalog and I'm going to buy this t-shirt over here. Buy it now. Okay. isabella009@gmail.com. First name is Isabella, last name is Matthew, company TVS, address Indus Town, okay, pin code, phone number, okay, continue to shipping. Continue to payment. Okay, so here you have to enter your credit card details. I am going to enter some test card details over here. Expiry date, security code, pay now. Okay, so you can see we have successfully placed our order and our order is confirmed. So now let's go to MailChimp and see if a new subscriber is added there or not. So I'll go to MailChimp. I'm just going to refresh this page once. Okay. So now here you can see isabella009@gmail.com is over here. First name is Isabella. Last name is Matthew. You can see tag is also here. Shopify order. It is subscribed. So we have successfully finished our integration and our integration is working fine. I'll go back to Public Connect and I'm going to explain you what has happened in our example. Okay. So in our example, what has happened is first the information went from Shopify to Public Connect and then from Public Connect, the information went to MailChimp. So now every time a new order is created in Shopify, automatically a new member or subscriber will be added in MailChimp. So we have successfully finished our integration of Shopify and MailChimp using Public Connect.
Not just these two software applications, but you can integrate any software application using Public Connect. If you have any queries, you can contact us at admin@pably.com and our team will help you. For more, you can also visit our website at www.pably.com. Thank you.